Hello everyone, welcome to another video from windowsloves.com, and today I'm going to show you how you can manage your multiple monitors in your remote desktop connection settings. So let's get started. So this video is for users who have multiple monitors and want to use only few of them, or want to use one monitor for the local PC and the rest of the monitors for remote desktop connections. So for example, if you have three monitors and if you want to use just two for remote desktop connection and leave the other one for your Spotify playlist, or if you want to watch a YouTube video while you are connected remotely to a remote computer. So this can be used in a different way. I'm going to show you how you can manage it yourself depending on what your needs are. Before we start, what we need to find out is how your system detects your monitors. So at the moment I have three monitors set up, so I'm going to see how my system determines which monitor is which. So first, start run, or just click on type here to search and type in run and type in mstsc space slash L, enter. And now, as you can see, it says remote desktop connections and there's three different monitors and there's different informations. With the important part is the numbers at the front of this display. So depending on how many monitors you have, you will see all of them listed here and there will be a number in front of them. Let's see how these numbers make sense to us. So leaving that open, right click on your display and click on display settings. And as you can see, I have three monitors here, but they're numbered in a different way. So I've got number one, number two, and number three, all right? The first thing you gotta know is which monitors you would like to use for the remote desktop connection and which ones you would not, or which ones you would like to use for YouTube video or just for your Spotify playlist or something, just for your local computer. So to do that, what you can do is click on identify. So what will happen now is you will see a number on the left hand corner of all the monitors, all the displays you have connected. Depending on that, you can choose which ones you would like to use for what purposes. All right, I'm going to click on identify. So number two would be the monitor that I would not want to use for the remote desktop connection. All right, so how would I not select number two? We're going to see that later. So let's see how these numbers make sense. The way to find out which monitors are which are, the lowest number here will be the lowest number here as well. So what happens is number zero is number one is number two, and number three is obviously number three. But sometimes you might have a different number here. It might be four, it might be 10. But the way the numbers are increasing here is the same way you can find out which monitors are connected to which monitors. All right, so number zero is number one for me. Number one is number two, and number three is obviously number three. And what I want to do is I want to skip number two and only use number one and number three for the remote desktop connections. All right, so once you've got that noted down, click on OK, close that, go back to search or run, or you can just hit Windows and R and type in mstsc without anything at the end, click on enter. So now enter the IP address or the computer name that you would like to connect. For me, it's 192.168.2.1.2.9. Can be a computer name or an IP address. Don't click connect yet. Click on show options. Go to display. Click on use all my monitors for the remote session. Go back to general again. And click on save. Click on save as. And save this as a remote desktop file, an RDP file. Anywhere that you can remember. I'm just going to save in desktop, rename it as remote connection. I'll save that and now I can close this. Now opened notepad, go on file, open, go to where the file was saved previously, click on all files, and you should see the remote desktop connection file there. Double click on it. So now you will see different textures. Scroll to the top, hit and enter, and type in selected monitors colon s colon. So now you would put in the monitors that you would like this remote connection to use. So for me, it was number 0 and number 3. So now I'm going to go ahead and file and save it. Close this, open the remote desktop connection, click on connect, enter the password. So once that's done, the remote desktop connection, we only use the monitors that you have selected. So now you can play around and try to find out the exact setup that you would like. And if you have two monitors, you can just use one monitor for your local PC, the other monitor for your remote desktop connection. All right, the only thing you got to keep in mind is for you to be able to use multiple monitors, the remote computer must have a supported version of Windows 10, at least Windows 10 Pro. So if you have a Windows 10 Home Edition, if you're on a remote connection, it will not allow you to use multiple monitors at remote desktop connection settings. So if you have any questions, leave it in the comments below. Like this video and subscribe for more. Thank you very much.